Jason Garrett every Monday during the season. San Antonio's sports leader, 1250 ESPN San Antonio. Presented by AA Best Bail Bonds. MyBestBailBonds.com.
Cowboys lose in overtime last night to the Washington Redskins, 20-17. Let's talk about it with the head coach of the Dallas Cowboys, Jason Garrett, joining us now courtesy of AA Best Bail Bonds. Coach, let's start with Tony Romo. I know he was going to have some tests this morning. Do we know the results of those tests yet?
No, we don't. He had some x-rays during the game last night, and those x-rays came back negative, which was positive for us, and he was able to go back in the game. But we were going to do some tests today, and we're still awaiting those results, and hopefully they'll turn out well for us.
Another injury update is Justin Durant, who became your leader here since the loss of Sean Lee. He's been a very important part of your defense here the first half of the season. There's rumors that he hurt his he was injured, he might be out for the season. Can you update that status, Durant, as well, Coach?
Well, I think you described him well. You know, when Sean got hurt, you know, we really needed some players on our team to step up and fill that leadership void and really that performance void as well. And Justin has done that as well as anybody, and really has had a great year. He was elected captain of our defense and has done a fantastic job. He tore his bicep last night in the game, and as you know, it's a very serious injury. You know, there are degrees to the tear, so we'll see what those are and what the course of action should be going forward with him. But suffice it to say, he's certainly going to miss some time, and it might be the rest of the season. But we still got to work out, you know, what we want to do on that based on all the information we get.
Dallas Cowboys head coach Jason Garrett with us here on 1250 ESPN San Antonio on the WilksAir.com hotline. Coach, with Tony Romo, when he went out, we saw on television it looked like he was trying to negotiate his way back in while visiting with the doctors. Can you take us through the process of allowing him back into that football game?
Yeah, ultimately it's a medical decision. So for us as coaches, it's a very unemotional thing. It's either the player has been cleared to play or not, and that applies to Tony and everybody else who has an injury during a game. And so Tony went in after he got hit in the back and got x-rays on his back, and they came back negative. And so the next step for him was to see how functional he could be. And he came back out and he moved around. He threw the ball a little bit. And, you know, initially there was some thought that he wasn't going to be able to come back. But, you know, as we continued to talk with him and as the medical people talked with each other, they felt like he was going to be able to come back and play. So certainly it's a medical decision. The doctors have the final say in those cases, but the input from the player is a big part of it, as long as he can function. So we did some stuff with him on the sidelines. It appeared like he was able to function, so then he subsequently was cleared to play, and we put him back in the ballgame.
Jason Garrett here with us on 1250 ESPN at San Antonio as he joins us each and every week following a Cowboys game. You lose that game in overtime. In the first half, it looked like it took a while for the offense to get in sync. You know, a lot of success running the football this year, yet, you know, last night, you know, a lot more throws than runs. What were they doing defensively besides the obvious blitzing that kept your offense from getting into sync?
Well, I actually thought we had pretty decent balance throughout the game. You know, DeMarco had over 100 yards again for us, and you know, I thought we did some good things in the passing game in the first half. And really, if you pull back and you evaluate games like this, it really can be pretty telling to you. We had five drives in the first half, and two of them we fumbled. Joseph Randall fumbled coming out after a good run, and then DeMarco had a nice completion, and we were down to about the 5-yard line going in, and the ball came out late in the down. So those were two of the possessions. A couple other ones, they bogged us down, they blitzed us on third down, and we didn't handle it very well. And then the last one was the 2-minute drive before the half. So, you know, one of the things that we really preach to our players is every play matters, because it's a play that impacts one of 10 or 11 drives that you have in the game. So if you have negative plays, if you have sacks, penalties, those kinds of things that get you behind the chains, it's hard to overcome that on really one of your 10 or 11 opportunities. And certainly if you turn the ball over, you know, by definition, you're sacrificing an opportunity to score points because they have the ball now. So, you know, I think if you look at it that way, there were some good things that happened. We ran it. We threw it. There were some positive plays. But we didn't string the drives together. And then when you get bogged down on the third downs and then you turn the ball over, you're really missing your chances.
Dallas Cowboy head coach Jason Garrett joining us here on 1250 ESPN, ESPNSA.com. Coach, when you scout teams, you have certain things that you look at for other teams or the players. And Colt McCoy hasn't started in the league in 3 years in his first start. How hard was it for your defense to find a tendency or find something that you can pick up because he hasn't played much in the game? And did his performance surprise you a little bit last night?
Well, no, we have a real healthy respect for him. All you have to do is watch the tape from last week. He went in the second half of that game. I think he completed 11 out of 12 and, mm-hmm. and moved him up and down the field and really helped them get a win against Tennessee. So, you know, we've seen him play before. Saw him in the preseason, saw him last week, and seen him a little bit throughout his career. Some coaches on our staff had actually been with him at different times, particularly a stop in Cleveland. So, you know, I think we had a pretty good feel for what he was all about. We think he's a good player, and he did a good job going in and running their offense, really doing what each play asked him to do. He made good decisions throughout the game, made good throws, moved the team, and the critical moments made some plays. So you got to give him credit. We didn't do enough to stop him defensively.
On the broadcast, Coach, we saw Jerry walk downstairs and onto the field. What did he say to you, and what are your feelings on communicating with ownership front office during games?
Well, he just was down there. He had been in the examining room with Tony and the doctors, and so he kind of hurried out and just as quickly as he could tried to get me the information about what the exam said, the x-ray being negative, and, you know, Tony possibly being able to come back in the game if he was functional on the sideline. So that's really all he said, and he wanted to get that communicated. It was not really a big deal to me at all.
Dallas Cowboy head coach Jason Garrett with us here on 1250 ESPN San Antonio. Coach, I know it's cliche, and I know how much you hate cliches, but sometimes the game is about blocking and tackling, and the Cowboys struggled in both of those areas last night. Is that what disappointed you most about the game?
Well, I believe strongly in cliches, and I believe probably as strongly in that one as any of them, because the cliches are cliches for a reason. And, you know, since the beginning of time, the game has been about, you know, the team that blocks the best and tackles the best and takes care of the football. Typically, that's the team that's going to win the game. So we've done a very good job of those things up to this point in the season, and we certainly didn't do our best job in those areas last night. Like we talked about, we turned it over twice, eliminating scoring opportunities for us. And I don't think we tackled very well last night. You know, at times we did, but other times some of our best tacklers, you know, didn't tackle like we typically do. And on some of those plays, there were possible no gains or even minus plays that turned into positive plays for them. And just a matter of getting back and making sure, you know, we do the things we're capable of doing in those fundamental areas. And, you know, the reference to the blocking, you know, really our third down protection wasn't as good as it could have been against some of their different pressures. A lot of times they're going to bring one more guy than you can block, and you have to get the ball out. You have to be able to make a play. You know, I said this earlier today. You have to be able to make little plays, and you have to be able to make big plays. And little plays is simply getting the ball out of your hand. Maybe you throw a flat or a slant, and you let the defense know that you have a good answer. And then, you know, if you're fortunate, maybe you break a tackle, and if they're in an all-out type blitz, you have an opportunity to really make a big play because there's nobody back there to help. So we weren't able to do that on a consistent basis last night. That's what bogged us down as much as anything else on offense.
Dallas Cowboy head coach Jason Garrett joining us here on 1250 ESPN San Antonio. Coach, and one bright spot last night was the play of Henry Melton, the guy you brought in as a free agent this past year. This offseason, he had two sacks. It seemed like he's getting his feet under him halfway through the season. He played some defensive end, which was surprising because he was so good at defensive tackle. Is that where he's going to be, where he has the flexibility to play inside and outside?
Well, he's a very good athlete. He's got great quickness and explosiveness when he's healthy. And I think he's getting healthier and healthier. And, you know, we wanted to give him some chances to rush on the inside against their guards, but we also wanted to give him a chance to work outside a little bit at that defensive end position. He showed up in the game. He got the sack, you know, working against the guard as a defensive tackle, but definitely had some pressures in both spots. And I thought it was probably the game where he was most active, around the ball the most, impacting the game the most. So hopefully that's a trend that will continue. You know, he's worked very hard to get himself back, you know, from that knee injury, and it seems like he's getting better and better every week.
You know, in this league, Coach, it seems like when you win, you feel like you'll never lose, and when you lose, you feel like you'll never win. This team is still 6-2, but how do you get your squad ready for next week with a short week when they're still, from their psyche, their point of view, coming off a disappointing loss, even though the team's 6-2?
Yeah, just get back to work. And, you know, we really believe in, you know, the dynamics of a work week. And like you said, it was a Monday night game, so the players are off today. They'll come back in tomorrow morning, and we'll clean up the game from last night really quickly, try to highlight some of the good things and certainly correct some of the things that weren't good enough in all three phases of our team, and then move forward quickly to get ready for the Arizona Cardinals. It's a big challenge for us this Sunday.
Coach Jason Garrett here on 1250 ESPN San Antonio. Nobody slipped you any test results while we were talking over the last 10 minutes. You don't want to break any news for us here this afternoon?
No, I've got no results.
All right. Coach, I appreciate the time as always. We'll talk to you next week after you beat Arizona.
Guys, I always enjoy it. You guys
appreciate
have a great
it.
Week.
Good luck, Coach.
Coach Jason Garrett here on 1250 ESPN San Antonio.
Jason Garrett, every Monday during the season. San Antonio's sports leader, 1250 ESPN San Antonio. Presented by AA Best Bail Bonds, mybestbailbonds.com.